Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu brushing off President Biden's call for a significant de-escalation. President Biden pressing Netanyahu to end the violence as Israel and Gaza trade a fresh round of rocket fire this morning. Will that ceasefire happen? We'll bring in now Thane Rosenbaum, distinguished university professor at Touro College. He's also the author of this book, Saving Free Speech from Itself. This push here by the president, still Netanyahu, saying if you're going to attack us, we'll continue to defend ourselves, in reference to Hamas firing rockets over Israel. Your thoughts on the conditions now and whether a ceasefire is likely?
Sean, remember, you know, Prime Minister Netanyahu, this is the fourth election they just had. And 2 years ago, when they first election, one of the problems people had with him is that after the 2014 war, he withdrew without taking out all of Gaza's rockets and tunnels. And the Israelis were not happy about that. And I'm sure that has something to do with why he's, to a large extent, brushing off some of this request from President Biden, because he really knows that the Israelis are watching that Hamas got better in the last 7 years. They're now able to fire 150 rockets at the same time headed toward Tel Aviv. That was never true before. Mm. And I think that Netanyahu, especially with these aborted elections, does not want to go back to the people and say, I left and there's still rockets and there's still tunnels.
Well, President Biden, as you know, you're talking money, restored hundreds of millions of dollars in Palestinian aid earlier this month as being called humanitarian aid. But it's reversing Trump's policy, blocking federal funds going towards the Palestinian Authority, Mahmoud Abbas, et cetera. You penned an op-ed in the Washington Post railing against lifting that financial freeze. I'll just read the headline. Palestinians are rewarding terrorists. The U.S. should stop enabling them. Do you still think that's what's happening?
Sean, just so the audience knows, they should all be seated. The best job for a Palestinian in the West Bank is to kill someone in Israel or be killed by someone in Israel. You get a monthly salary. You can get a month. You can get a lump sum payment. If you're killed, your family gets 1,600 lump sum. The salaries can be anywhere between $570 to $3,400 a month. The United States gives President Biden just restored $290 million, and this pay for slay program that the Palestinians have is for $300 million. So it looks like, remember, President Trump brought it down to zero. And you want to know why? Because he looked Abbas in the eye and he said, please tell me you're not providing lavish incentives and a vocation for killing Israelis. And by the way, the Taylor Force Act was named after a Christian American who was in Israel with his buddies after serving in Afghanistan and Iraq, who was killed by a Palestinian terrorist, and his parents discovered that his family received the lump sum payment, and his funeral was televised on television. They couldn't believe it. They said, that can't be right. Abbas lied to President Trump. He said, Mr. President, we would never do anything like that. He went back and laughingly, in Arabic, said to his people, the Americans think we're so stupid, we're gonna give up the martyrs program. We're never gonna give up the martyrs program. And you know what President Trump did? He slashed the budget to zero.
Yeah,
and so now that $290 million has been restored, Sean, I have no idea. Money is fungible. Money that can be in one line can be used to a different line. The
right.
State Department will probably say it's being earmarked for something else.
Humanitarian
but
aid, specifically, it's being earmarked for that. But what you're alleging is, what is the Palestinian Authority doing with that money?
And under Oslo, they're in violation of Oslo. It requires the Palestinian Authority to renounce terror and prevent terror,
right,
not to turn terror into a vocation, incentivize it with lavish benefits and give it a profit motive.
All right, I'm out of time. Thane, thanks so much. Thane Rosenbaum joining us live. We appreciate it.